गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज़ ऑन वेटिंग लाइन मॉडल. सो दिस वेटिंग लाइन मॉडल इज ऑल्सो रेफर्ड एज क्यूइंग मॉडल और क्यूइंग थ्योरी. सो दिस आर द कंटेंट ऑफ आवर टॉपिक. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वेटिंग लाइन मॉडल. देन वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस सिस्टम्स इन वेटिंग लाइन मॉडल और सिस्टम्स इन क्यूइंग मॉडल. Then we have to discuss about the different types of waiting line models. Then we have to discuss about the various terms and symbols or notations used in order to solve the numerical also. And finally we have to practice some numerical. So why we have to study this model? So we know that when we approach to the bank or for any system, so we find that there are more than one customers, and all that customers are sent to the respective counters in order to complete their transaction. So in this banking system, so waiting line model is applicable, or in this system we use the waiting line model. So similarly in hospitals or in on roads for the traffics or in daily routine also we can use the principles of waiting line model. So let us discuss about this model. Now this waiting line model or this queuing model is the mathematical study of waiting lines or queues. So we have to analyze the various waiting lines of the customer or various queues of the customer, and we have to satisfy these queues or we have to satisfy the waiting line customers in order to complete their task. And in order to satisfy the queues or in order to satisfy the customers in a line, then we have to adopt the best methodology. So what is the optimum methodology or what is the optimum solution for the customer waiting in the queues? So that we have to achieve. So in order to achieve this optimum solution, we have to use the principles of waiting line techniques. Again, as discussed, we can use this technique for so many applications, such as for telecommunication, that is for telephone lines or for the telephone networks. Again, we use the principles of these models for traffic engineering, that is planning of the traffic on various roads in the cities. Nowadays we will find that in Pune all the roads are with lot of traffic, and we have to manage this traffic, and our RTO department works on this traffic planning. So that also comes under the waiting line model. Again, we have to discuss about planning of various jobs or various products in a factories, or we can use this waiting line for servicing the customer at various shops or at malls, again for various government offices as well as the schools and college offices, and for various hospitals. So these are the some of the applications of waiting line model, and we will practice numerical based on this application in our further discussion. Now let us discuss about the queuing system as well as the basic definition of queue. So what is queue? So queue is a group of customers or items waiting at some place to receive attention or service, including those receiving the service. And in our queuing system there are four important elements. In the next slide we will discuss about this queuing system in detail. So what are the four important element of the queuing system? So this queuing system depends on the input pattern, or it depends on the arrival pattern. Again, this system depends on service mechanism or service pattern, that is how the service is provided to the customer. Then next it depends on queue discipline, and finally it depends on the behavior of the customers in the queue in order to attain the particular job. So these are the four important pillars of queuing system. So let us discuss about these four important pillars in detail in the next slide. So this is the layout of waiting line models. So in these models we have input, that is input system for this model. So this is the output, and this is the in-between service mechanism. Again, let us consider we have to process certain jobs on different machines, or we may consider that is customer coming to the bank for their transaction, or you may consider customer patient coming to the hospitals, number of patients coming to the hospitals for the treatment. So that is our input. So here we take into account these customers or jobs or person coming to the system. Again, what is the arrival pattern of this customer? That is also important. And mostly in this waiting line model, we use probability and statistics principles. So in probability and statistics, we have studied the various types of probability distributions. Particularly, we have normal distribution, binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, and so on. So here, what is the arrival pattern? So what is the distribution of that arrival? That also we have to take into account. And what is their type of distribution, whether we have Poisson distribution or normal distribution, accordingly we utilize that that is parameters related to that. Again, it depends on the configuration of the queue. What is the type of the queue we have, or what is the type of customer in a queue? That also we have to analyze. Again, it depends on the queue discipline. And finally, it depends on the service process or service mechanism. So in order to service the customer, we have single channel system or we have multi channel system. So we will discuss about the single channel system and multi channel system in detail in the when we will take into account the different models for solving the numerical also. And finally, how that customer is going out from this system, that is also important. So we can take the feedback of this customer so that we can improve our system accordingly. So finally, what is the objective of this waiting line model? So we have to satisfy each and every customer coming to the system, and we have to provide the good practice or good service to the customers so that the customer will reach to their home with good satisfaction or with good expectation. So that is the main objective of these models. So once again, we'll take into account all these terms in detail in further slide. Now let us discuss in brief about the same system. So first about, we'll discuss about the input process or input of the waiting line system. Then next we'll discuss about the service mechanism of the system, and then the final output of the system. So again, in input process, it depends on four parameters. It depends on size of the arrivals. It depends on inter arrival time. Again, it depends on capacity of the service system, and it depends on the customer behavior or type of customer coming to the system or coming to the channel. Now again, size of the arrival, it depends on the pattern or distribution. So mostly we follow here Poisson distribution for deciding the arrival pattern, or it we also takes into account the random pattern. Then inter arrival time, again here we take into account the exponential distribution or gamma distribution or Erlang distribution. So again, we have studied the distribution pattern, that is probability distribution in statistics and probability. So that principle once again we have to recall here in this model. Then next parameter in input process is capacity of the service system, is how much customer they can service or they can accommodate in the system. That also we have to take into account. And finally, the behavior of the customer, whether the customers they are expecting more than the system requirement and all, that also we have to take into account. The next important parameter in the waiting line system is service mechanism or service facility. Again, the service facility or service mechanism depends on two parameters. It depends on service facility design, or it depends upon the queue discipline or service discipline. Again, under service facility design, so we may have, the system may have single channel facility or it may have multi-channel facility. So single channel means, let us consider the example of the petrol pump. So on petrol pump, there are different channels for distribution of the diesel or the petrol. Again, if you have more than one machines on the petrol pump, so it comes under the multi-channel discipline. And if there is only one counter or only one machine for servicing the customer, so then it comes under the single channel facility. So depending upon this facility, we have different types of waiting line model. So we have single channel model and we have multi-channel model. So that we'll take into account, or that we'll discuss in further slides. Again, what is the service discipline and what pattern we follow in the service discipline is also important. So mostly we follow first in and first out pattern, that is FIFO pattern, or we also take into account the first come first serve pattern, that is FCFS pattern. So that is one discipline pattern. Second is also we take into account the service in random order, that is SIRO pattern. So we'll discuss about this pattern once again in detail in our further discussions. Now let us discuss about the type of waiting line problems. Again, when you talk about the different models of waiting line theory, then we have to take into account various terms used in this waiting line. So let us discuss about this term. So first is about the queue length, then waiting time, service time, then average idle time or busy time distribution. So first we'll discuss about these terms one by one. So first of all, about the queue length. So queue length is the probability of distribution of queue or the number of persons in the system at any point of time. And further, we can estimate the probability that there is no queue. Means finally, we have to reduce the queue to zero. So that is our objective. So what are the number of queues or number of persons in a queue that define the queue length? The next is waiting time. So waiting time is the, again, it deals with the probability distribution of waiting time of customer in the queue. So the time required for a particular customer to wait in a queue for the service to be achieved. Then next is the service time. Again, it is the time taken for servicing a particular arrivals. Means again, the time required for the number of jobs or number of persons coming to the channel or coming to the system. So that is the time required for that customers. And average idle time or busy time distribution time is the average time for which the system remains idle. That is also important, because always we have to optimize our resources and there should not be any idle time in our system. So if there is more idle time, mean directly it will affect the quality as well as the production, or it affects the performance of our system. So that's why there must be zero idle time. That is the important parameters. Then let us discuss about the various symbols or the notations used in different models. And basically we define the queue model by this fashion. So A oblique B oblique S as to D oblique F. This is the designation of waiting line models. So in this model, what is A stands for, what is B stands for, and what is S, D and F stands for, that we'll see in brief. So A, capital A, stands for arrival pattern of the unit. Again, it is the arrival pattern given by the probability distribution of inter arrival time of the units. Again, B is the probability distribution of service time of individual being actually served. For example, the service time follows negative exponential distribution and 10 units are served in 10 minutes or the service time is 3 minutes. So this A and B, these are the important parameter, and that defines rest of the element of the system. Then S, capital S in this model, it is the number of service channels, whether we have single channel system or multi channel system, that is defined with the capital S. Then next, small d stands for capacity of the system, means how much customer or how much persons we can serve in our system. So that is defined by small d. Then small f, it is the manner or order in which the arriving units are taken into service, whether we have to take into account FIFO model or LIFO model or SIRO model. So that depends on type of model or type of order that we take into account. So this is the general designation of any models, and accordingly we take into account here this capital A, capital B, capital S, small d and F terms, and accordingly we define the models. That also we'll see in detail in further slide. Again, it is the continuation of the same. In addition to the previous notations or symbols, we have some additional notation like capital YX, then YW and so on. So one by one we'll see all these models or all these symbols. Once we take into account, and all these symbols are taken into consideration, or it will take into account whatever model we will discuss further. So in that models, some of the symbols are referred. So it is a list of all the symbols referred in all the models of waiting line theory. So capital X is the inter arrival time between two successive customers or arrivals. Then capital Y is the service time required by any customers. Then small w is that waiting time for any customer before it is taken into service. Then small v is the time spent by the customer in the system. Then small n, number of customers in the system, and that is the customer in the waiting line at any time, including the number of customers being served. Then PN, P capital P suffix N, it is the probability that N customer service arrive in the system in time T. Again, this probability is a function of time always. Then phi is the probability of that N units are arrived in a time T. Then capital U, again it is U of T, probability of distribution of inter arrival time, that is such that small t is always less than or equal to capital T. Then capital V, it is probability distribution of servicing time, that is again probability of T less than or equal to capital T. Then capital F, it is a probability distribution of Q length at any time, again the probability of capital N always less than or equal to small n. Then EN, that is capital E suffix N, it is the state of the system at a time where there are N units in the system. Then lambda suffix N, it is the average number of customers arriving per unit time when there are already N units in the system. Then lambda, it is the average number of customers arriving per unit time. Then mu suffix N, it is the average number of customers being served per unit time when there are already N units in the system. And then mu, it is the average number of customers being served per unit time. Then 1 by lambda, it is the inter arrival time between the two arrivals. 1 by mu, it is the service time between the two units or customers. Then rho, it is the system utility, or it is also referred as traffic intensity, which tells us how much time the system was utilized in a given time. For example, we have given time 8 hours and accordingly the traffic intensity is 3/8. So this indicates that, it means to say that out of 8 hours the system is used for 3 hours, means 8 minus 3, that is 5 hours is idle. So again this traffic intensity gives us the idle time for the particular system, or it indicates the percentage of utilization of the system, and always we expect this traffic intensity should be always equal to 1, that is in idle practice. Now let us discuss about the different queue models, because theory point of view most of the questions asked on this model are for 6 marks or for 8 marks, and these questions are asked in May 2018 or May 2016. Sometimes there may be questions on basic definitions or basic terms used in the queue models, and finally there will be numerical for 8 to 10 marks. Again, numericals are very simple. If you know the particular formula or particular model, then easily we can solve the numerical in exam. So this topic is again scoring point of view, this is very important. So let us discuss about the various models. So we classify broadly the models into two category, that is we have probabilistic models and deterministic models. Again, probabilistic models, in probabilistic models both arrival and service rates are some unknown random variables, means that are not fixed. Whereas deterministic models, in deterministic models both arrivals and service rates are known and fixed. So deterministic models is exactly opposite of probabilistic models. So mostly we will discuss about the deterministic models, and in engineering for undergraduation study most of the models whatever we study under the operation research are deterministic models. We have only introduction of probabilistic models, because this probabilistic models is the part of higher studies of engineering, and mostly it is added for post graduation. So whatever models we discuss under operation research under for undergraduation, all the models are mostly deterministic models. So likewise here also, in our today's discussion or in the next discussion, we will take into account only the deterministic models. Again, sometimes we have to refer the combined models, or that is the mixed models. So it is the combination of deterministic models and probabilistic models, so that is referred as the mixed models. So in mixed model we are taking into account the arrival and service rate, that is unknown as well as known for particular applications. Now let us again define, this is the designation of the any model of waiting line theory. So just we have discussed this in previous slide. Again, we define the models by this terminology also. In that distribution or in the model description, we use capital M, capital D, capital E and capital G. So this capital M is used to denote the Poisson distribution or Markovian distribution of arrival and departures. Capital D is the term used to determine the constants or to define the deterministic distribution constant. Then E suffix K is used to represent Argalian probability distribution, and capital G, it is used to show how general probability distribution takes place. So this is the introduction of the queuing models, and in the next lecture we'll discuss about the different models one by one, and we'll practice numerical based on these models. So today we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next lecture. Thank you.